Ladies and gentlemen, Marc Ashley.
Good afternoon, everyone. Today is bittersweet for me because I'm both excited to celebrate and honor a great man and friend, yet I'm still in mourning for him. I had the privilege to be and call Tony Bowling a close friend and brother for 25 years. When I learned of Tony's passing in December, I was a total mess. At Tony's funeral, I delivered a eulogy that allowed me to make my mess my message to my fellow mourners. Tony's life was taken away from us way too soon, and it's hard to understand why things like that happen. If you knew Tony, you already know that he was a dear friend, devoted husband, and a loyal son and brother. Today we are here to celebrate Tony's life, pay respect to all of the remarkable things that Tony accomplished, and to honor his legacy with the first ever Tony Bowling Award. Tony touched the lives of everyone he knew and led a wonderful life. We know that he is in a better place now and take comfort in that. I could never put into words how incredible Tony was. Responsible and responsive. Intelligent, caring, and so loving. I could go on and on and on. I knew that I could trust him with anything, and I respected him more than you could ever imagine. A word of praise from Tony, if you knew him, meant the world to you. It meant the world to you. I miss Tony very much. However, I know that since Tony was such a positive person, he would not want us to be sad today. If he were here, he would tell us to cheer up, smile, and remember all of the great memories that we all shared together. I would like to share some of my memories with you today. I first met Tony over 25 years ago. I immediately knew this was a warm, friendly, humble, and incredibly caring person. I also immediately knew that Tony was a serial entrepreneur. What does that mean? That means that Tony could never work for anyone. Ever work for anyone. In addition, at that time, we wanted Tony and his beautiful wife, Pam, to be part of our Market America family. Maybe you remember at that time, Tony was hustling the photo book, Frank. Remember the photo book? Yes, the photo book. The perfect service for the camera enthusiast, including Elizabeth, free Kodak film for life. Remember Tony and Pam used to say this on stage? And after all, memories are forever. As with any successful entrepreneur, you have your ups and downs. 25 years ago when I met Tony, it was not the best time for him. I remember as it was just yesterday, the really cool van, if you remember, that Tony and Pam drove when they first were building the business. I remembered when I was young at that time, and I wanted one of those nice vans so badly. I knew it would not take long for Tony to be successful again, because everyone wanted to be around and associated with Tony. And I was right. It did not take Tony very long to be successful. Tony knew that if you want the rainbow, you have to put up with the rain. Well, the rest is history. Together, Tony and Pam became two of the most accomplished, respected, and successful entrepreneurs our company has ever known. On top of that, even with his amazing success, he never changed once. And was always the same loving and caring individual that he always was. I have so many wonderful and fond memories of Tony. I could stand up here all day and night if I went through all of them, if I had the time. I'd love to. One that really sticks out to me among the many is when J.R. Loren and I took Tony and Pam to go see a Miami Dolphins Indianapolis Colts game in Miami. We all went to the game, took Tony and Pam. I think a few other UFOs went. I think Kevin, Dennis were there too. Tony was a big Colts fan because they were originally in Baltimore, Frank, and then they moved to Indianapolis, and he was equally a big fan of Peyton Manning. I was a huge Dolphin fan since I was a kid, Marty, so we get to the game. By the way, Tony is not a gambler, but we're there. He's for Indy. I'm for Miami. We make a gentleman's bet of $100. $100 if Miami wins, he pays me, and vice versa. So, game's over. Indianapolis beats Miami. I don't carry much cash on me. I just don't. I don't carry a lot of cash in general. And I didn't have $100 on me at the time. So, the next morning, the game's on a Sunday. Monday morning, I'm in Miami, I call my assistant, I said, Kitty, you gotta write a check to Tony Bowling for $100 and overnight it to him today so he gets it on Tuesday morning. True story. Tuesday morning, first thing, Tony gets the check. First thing on Tuesday morning, I get a call, it's Tony. Marc, it's Tony. Goes, I got your $100 check. He goes, I just want you to know I'm not going to cash the check. I'm sitting in my office right now. He goes, I'm going to frame it into my office. He goes, you are the only individual in my whole lifetime who has ever paid me on a bet that I have won. True story. He goes, I'm not cashing the check. I'm framing it in my office because you were the only person who has ever paid me back on a bet. That's the way Tony went. And when I got that call, for him to tell me that and for me to follow through with paying him made me feel so good, because if you were like me, again, if Tony said something to you, Joe, like you look good today or you're doing a good job, it meant more to me than almost anyone saying it, because he didn't give you those kind of compliments unless he meant it. Unless he meant it, he would never say those things. Of all the incredible characteristics of Tony, I believe that the most important to him, and the people who know and love him know this, was that he was a man of faith. He was a man of faith. He always gave all of the glory to Christ, and he always let you know it. Always let you know it. Tony made sure that everyone knew that he was a man of God. He loved his church, First Baptist Church. As I stand up here, I'm thinking about what would Tony say to us right now if he could. I truly believe it's what the great Billy Graham said. Someday you will read or hear that Billy Graham is dead. Don't you believe a word of it. I shall be more alive than I am now. I will have just changed my address. I will have gone into the presence of God. Yeah. Tony would want us to take time every day to thank God for all of the years we had together. Let us please take a moment to applaud Tony's life and rejoice in the fact that he truly lived, and JR made the most of his dash. After Tony passed, J.R. Loren and the corporate team decided to create the Tony Bowling Award as our way of honoring our incredible brother. Today, I am thrilled to be able to announce and present the first ever winner of the Tony Bowling Award. Before we do that, Loren, I'd like to see if you'd come up here with me. Loren and team.
Just so you know, just want to add something. When we went to Tony's funeral, and went to his house, I was with Pam, and I asked Pam, can I just go sit in Tony's office for a little while? And she said, really? I had the office locked, but if you want to, sure. I said, would you mind? And she said, not at all. And I went in there, Marc, and that check was on the wall. That check was on the wall. And just being in the presence of Tony's office was so powerful, because you could kind of walk down memory lane of 27 years together. Every award, every first check, every moment, right, Andrew? It was pretty amazing. And I know, just so you know, the only reason JR's not up here, it's very hard for him right now. So it was a magical moment, you know. And we'll never forget Tony. We love him, his humor, everything about him. Tony was everything. He is the heart of Market America. He really is.
Loren, you know, you know, being at Tony's house that day, it was like, you felt like you were in Market America.
I felt like it was an extension of the company.
Yeah,
exactly.
So Loren and team, family, we put together this short video to celebrate Tony's life. And so
let's take a look at it.
Let's take a look at the video.
JR has what he calls the magic moments, okay? And the magic moments are what he considers to be the tipping point of success. We've got thousands of them. It includes all of our friends and people that we work with and everything that's special to the company. It really is moving fast.
Well, we really love each and every one of you, because it really has been our philosophy for years that it takes all of us for any one of us to succeed. And I think that's so true. So thanks to the new people, and just keep coming back. You'll be glad you did. Thank you very much.
There's nothing boring about our business. You got the pedal to the metal, no matter what it is.
Tony, we love and we miss you.
A lot.
We love and we miss you a lot. As I mentioned, this is the first ever presentation of the Tony Bowling Award. The criteria that we set for this prestigious award are very simple and true to the core of who Tony was. And it's just three words: loyalty, integrity, and character. We would like to announce and present the first ever Tony Bowling Award. Should I do this? Yeah.
Whatever you want.
We'll do it after.
Okay.
And the winner?
The winner is Pam Bowling.
Thank you.
let me. So, okay, Howard. Let me do this fast. Lisa, I hope you can call her and let her listen. But this is so hard. But Pam has been so amazing taking care of Tony. So amazing over the last year and a half taking care of Tony that she didn't take care of herself. And just a few months after Tony passed, she was diagnosed with stage 4 cancer. Now, listen to me. We are not here to mourn Pam. We're here to celebrate Pam. I am not crying. I am not crying because I'm mourning her. I'm crying because I have to speak for her. She is a lady. Beautiful. She is a queen. She has put her man first. She put this business first. And when it was time to check in with herself, she missed that checkup. So here's the thing. I don't know if you hear us right now, Pam. I don't know if you're watching. I've been talking to her every single week. Some days it's better than others. Every week I talk to her, it's hard. Pam, as much as she missed Tony, wished for a real renaissance of her life. And I'm praying to God right now that you give her one. You see, when we talk about the atmosphere earlier, this atmosphere is filled with Pam and Tony's spirit.
Sorry.
They're here. We'll always be here. Forever we'll be here. And as Dare says, never forget where you came from. You may not be able to find your way home. We never forget the long, lonely roads, Dare said, that he rode with Tony and Pam to build this business. They believed in him when very few people did. Pam, if you're listening, we love you. In your packets, guys, I put a card. It's a well wishes card. And I want you to leave her a message from your heart if you loved her, if she touched you in any way. And you can leave that message in the convention services in the plaza, drop it in there, and we will mail them to her overnight. I want her to wake up and get a whole big box from us of love. And I know Pam didn't want me to talk about her being sick, but I know that she wants you to understand why she's not here. And I know one thing. Jaren and I told her a couple weeks ago, listen, you're a beast. You go in beast mode and you be a beast. And you fight this. God never gives us anything we can't handle. You got this, Pam. We got you. God's got you and we got you. We love you so much. We love you so much. You deserve this so much because without Pam, there is no Tony Bowling.
We love you, Pam. Give it up for Pam Bowling.